Welcome to this session on batteryless Z-Stack 3.x. This training will provide an understanding of the Zigbee 3.0 Green Power feature, which introduces the potential of batteryless devices operating in a Zigbee network. Using Zigbee Green Power, certain home automation devices may now be powered by energy harvesting solutions, reducing the environmental impact of batteries. I'm Toby Pan, an applications engineer on the SimpleLink Apps team. My goal in this training is to give you a high-level understanding of Zigbee 3.0 and its Green Power feature. We'll discuss what the Green Power feature is, how it can benefit certain applications, and TI's implementation of Zigbee. TI's SimpleLink product line offers a rich portfolio of low-power wireless MCUs. We make it easier for developers to adjust and adapt to changing design or application requirements, and to even enter into new markets with the same base product. The new SimpleLink MCU platform brings together industry-leading connectivity solutions with TI's proven ARM-based MCUs. This platform provides a single development environment with 100% code reuse across all of these devices. A one-time investment with a SimpleLink software development kit allows customers to reuse often, opening the door to create unlimited applications. Note that Zigbee-capable devices are outlined in red. First, we will provide a brief overview of what Zigbee is and what it's typically used for. Next, we'll dive into the Zigbee Green Power feature, which allows batteryless devices to operate in a Zigbee network. Then, we'll introduce TI's offerings and resources for Zigbee. Finally, we'll show how you can easily evaluate a demo with Green Power devices. One of the wireless protocols supported by the SimpleLink CC13x2 26x2 devices is Zigbee. This is an open wireless mesh protocol. Zigbee is notable for its high interoperability. Products must pass Zigbee certification in order to bear the Zigbee logo. This interoperability also applies, in a sense, to the application layer via a common Zigbee cluster library. Zigbee is ideal for home automation applications, a market where it has thrived for over 10 years, for example, in lights, thermostats, and smart plugs. The latest revision, Zigbee 3.0, introduces features to enhance security and improve network management. The following diagrams show the network topology and the software architecture of Zigbee. The building blocks of any Zigbee network are the device types. The three device types are coordinator, router, and end device. The coordinator is responsible for initially forming the network, then allowing other devices to join. Any Zigbee network consists of at most one coordinator. Routers are what enable mesh networking. They are responsible for routing packets across the network. A coordinator also performs routing duties. End devices are low-power devices, which may sleep for the majority of the time. This allows them to be battery-powered. They send messages into the network strictly through their current parent. Conversely, any message targeting an end device must be routed to its parent, who will hold on to that message until the end device pulls the parent for pending messages. From the example Zigbee network, there is one coordinator, multiple routers, and multiple end devices. Note that a router may communicate directly with multiple devices, and that end devices only directly communicate with their parent device. As you can see how the software is arranged, interoperability is practically implied. Each node runs common MAC and PHY layers. These layers take care of transmitting and receiving packets over the air. The MAC and PHY are based on the IEEE 802.15.4 standard, which is designed for low data rate, low power applications. The network layer handles association of devices, for example neighbors and parents, and also maintains routing paths. The other layers provide support to the application layer. They allow for devices to behave similar to each other and enable the interoperability that was mentioned earlier. For the most part, the developer can safely assume that all non-application layers work flawlessly. This allows them to focus on adding differentiation within the application layer. The application will be based on the Zigbee cluster library, or ZCL for short, which provides an extensive list of application definitions through clusters. Examples of clusters include the on-off cluster, the door lock controller cluster, the thermostat cluster, and the temperature sensor cluster. Use of the clusters defined in ZCL is necessary for Zigbee certified devices from different manufacturers to interoperate seamlessly. Going back to the device types, typically coordinators will be found on smart home hubs as these are connected to the internet. This allows the consumer to control their Zigbee enabled home products from a remote location. Routing devices must always have their RF receiver on and should be mains powered. However, this is the only requirement. The developer is free to implement whatever other application they like on routing devices, such as lights, fan controls, and thermostats. Coordinators also perform routing duties. End devices are not required to have their RF receiver on 100% of the time. This allows them to be battery powered. For network management purposes, they should periodically poll their parents as a keep alive. Other than that, usually end devices will send messages based on asynchronous events, for example button presses and smoke detection. Now with a sufficient understanding of Zigbee, we can delve into Zigbee's Green Power feature. This feature allows batteryless devices to operate in a Zigbee network. Of course, batteryless does not equal energyless. There are a number of sources where energy can be captured and converted for an MCU to use. These sources include button presses, temperature fluctuations, and ambient light. We'll learn what the specific terms mean, but green power devices, potentially batteryless, can send green power data frames, which will be forwarded by green power proxies until they reach the destination green power sinks. Again, that's a lot of vernacular that hasn't been discussed yet, but will be shortly. Here are the green power devices which we will discuss. All the code which implement these is provided. The developer needs only to enable the feature and include the necessary files. The SDK includes two green power device examples, switch and temperature sensor. Routing devices enable a green power proxy basic by default. Routing devices may also enable green power combo basic by defining enable green power combo basic and adding the necessary green power sync files. End devices are considered reduced function devices, that is, they are not necessary to maintain a Zigbee network. However, the packets they send must still be standard Zigbee compliant packets, usually around 50 bytes or so. They are also capable of receiving commands from their parents. The green power device may be considered a fourth logical device type. They are designed to be used in very low power operation where they are intended to only send very simple commands. These small commands are called GPDFs, which is short for Green Power Data Frames. In our SimpleLink software development kit, we have the Green Power Device Switch, which implements a simple switch. The macro batteryless device may be defined for batteryless operation of the switch. In batteryless operation, the switch sends one Green Power toggle command after starting up. Coupled with the energy harvesting switch TI design, developers can easily evaluate the benefits of green power devices. We have a guide in the SDK which goes over details of green power device example projects and how to use them. The design files, BOM, and other collateral related to TIDA 00690 is available on TI.com for the customer to construct an energy harvesting switch. The destination of command sent by a green power device is for one or more green power sinks. You may notice that there's a difference in the output of the green power device and the inputs of the green power sink. The green power device transmits green power data frames, but the green power sink does not receive green power data frames, but rather green power cluster commands. Remember that the green power data frame is not a standard Zigbee packet. Thus, in order to pass the command to the application layer, the ZStack needs to convert the green power data frame into a Zigbee application compliant format through the Zigbee cluster library. This is done through the green power cluster. The green power cluster must be implemented on endpoint hex F2, which is reserved specifically for the green power cluster. The user should implement and register callbacks for the green power cluster. When a green power sink receives a green power command that was tunneled from a paired green power device, it would appropriately call the application callback which will control the specific hardware, for example, a light. This device serves as a proxy for green power devices. They will represent the green power device and forward the command as if the green power device were a normal logical device type. Once the green power data frame has reached the proxy, then we can assume, given a perfect mesh network, that the green power command will successfully reach the destination sink. Note that it may be possible for multiple proxies to be in RF range of the green power device frame, resulting in multiple of the same message propagating through the mesh network. Thus, the sinks and proxies discard a green power command if they have received this command with a given sequence number before. All routing devices must implement the green power proxy basic. The green power combo basic device combines the functionality of the proxy and sync. It is able to receive a green power command as a green power cluster command or as a raw green power data frame. It may also be paired with the green power device to execute the command sent to it by the paired green power device. While routing devices are not forced to implement this type of green power device type, it is recommended to do so for forwards compatibility. That is, if, in the future, green power devices will be added to the network, then the green power combo basic can pair with that green power device. Enabling green power combo basic adds about 6 kilobytes to the hex image. We can refer to this application report for some power consumption measurements of a green power device and also end devices. As you can see, given the same output power, one ZCL toggle command is equivalent to about 4 green power data frame toggle commands. Although the 4 green power data frames are duplicates, you can see that if both an end device and a green power device are battery powered, the green power device could potentially provide 4 times more toggle operations. Since green power devices consume such low power to operate, you may wonder why not all end devices are replaced with green power devices. Remember that the reasons green power devices can have such low current consumption are that they do not periodically pull a parent and that the packets they send are on average much shorter than normal Zigbee packets. Thus, green power devices are useful for simple devices which will remain unchanged for the majority, if not all, of their lifetimes, such as switches, dimmers, and temperature sensors. Also, it is possible to OTA upgrade an end device, which gives users the flexibility of upgrading their devices with new features. Here are some closing notes on green power. Developers do not need to worry about green power proxy basic functionality, as this is enabled in all routing device examples in the SDK. Although it is optional to implement the sync functionality for routing devices seeking Zigbee 3.0 compliance, we strongly recommend developers to consider the use cases for green power device controlled devices and to implement the sync functionality. For currently deployed products which do not have the sync functionality, it is possible to OTA upgrade them so that they do. For quick steps on how to run green power examples out of box, please refer to the green power device application overview, which is provided with the SDK and also TI Resource Explorer. As the heart of SimpleLink is connectivity, what could be better than connecting a device to a smartphone or tablet through Bluetooth Low Energy? In the latest SDK, we include a dynamic multi-protocol manager which allows two concurrently running stacks to share the same radio. It includes the use cases of end device plus BLE and router plus BLE. The router implements the green power proxy basic by default, but a few simple steps and it can also implement the green power sync, making it a green power combo basic. With this dynamic multi-protocol manager, it is possible to toggle the light on the router three ways: from the coordinator, from the smart device, or from a green power device powered by an energy harvesting switch. For design files and user's guide on the energy harvesting switch, please see TIDA 00690 on TI.com. TI Z-Stack offers a complete Zigbee solution and is included in the SimpleLink CC13x2 26x2 SDK. It is currently certified with the latest Zigbee Pro 2017 specification, R22, and the Green Power Proxy specification, version 1.1.1. This SDK provides the user all the necessary code to develop Zigbee applications on the CC2652R1 and CC1352R1 devices. To take an initial glance at the current SDK, you need look no further than TI Resource Explorer. It contains descriptions of the example projects and helpful documentation such as user's guides for the protocol stacks. You can also find SimpleLink Academies that provide step-by-step instructions on running highly used examples and features. For Zigbee specifically, we have SimpleLink Academies ranging across all levels of expertise. These include getting a simple Zigbee network up and running, how to use ZStack security features to protect centralized networks, and how to add a cluster to a Zigbee application. For initial application development, we provide the TI LaunchPad ecosystem, which gives users a solid out-of-box experience. These LaunchPads are orderable from TI.com and are relatively inexpensive, allowing easy access to a world of innovative application development. If you have any questions on the content presented, please feel free to post on our Zigbee E2E support forum. Thank you for joining me today in learning about the Zigbee 3.0 Green Power feature. Happy development!